We have moved into the FM 101.9 Music Hall. Nicole Sandler here looking at Peter Stewart and Tim, what's your last name?
Bradshaw.
Mm-hmm. The band is Dog's Eye View, but Peter Stewart is the visionary. He's the guy with the sight, right? A New York native who for many years toured solo, playing coffee houses and opening for Counting Crows and other bands, building a loyal following. So it was those tours that led to the record deal?
Yeah, pretty much. We'll find out if that following is loyal, by the way. Tonight we start our tour up in San Francisco, so if there are people there, it's a loyal following. If not, they're just, you know, they're just
following
fickle.
Somebody else.
Exactly.
Well, kicking it off in San Francisco now, a lot of your base was built opening for Counting Crows.
Yeah.
And that's their home base, kind of, although they're down here now.
Yeah. I mean, we had great shows there. I think the best show of my life was up in San Jose. It's this 4,000 seat venue, and just, you know, one of those nights where everything went well. It's really cool.
So you're after this, you're going to the airport, you're flying up to San Francisco for a show there, and then back down here tomorrow.
Yeah, absolutely, to play at the Troubadour.
Troubadour tomorrow night. Now, some of us actually got a preview of that on Saturday night, which was wonderful, and we'll talk a little bit about that later. This is actually your second visit, though, to KSCA, the first one in the music hall.
Mm-hmm.
The first time you're in here, but the last time you were here, I don't know if you remember, because you did a lot of these, but you played a little gig for us in the conference room.
Oh, I do remember, yeah. I remember it because it's one of those. This is one of those stations that I was crossing my fingers and hoping would play us, because it's every when I came out here and mixed the record, it was the station I listened to, and it was that kind of thing where I was just, you know, it's like walking into a place and hoping your family likes you. You know, like, I like this station, I hope they like me.
Cool. So. Well, we did. I mean, that was a fun day, and we are thrilled to have you back here. Peter Stewart, Dog's Eye View, tomorrow night at the Troubadour. Want to give us a preview of what all of us who go can hear?
Absolutely. Let's.
A song.
Tim, shall we play Everything Falls Apart?
Sure.
Here we go. 1, 2, 3. Don't look now. Things just gotten worse. I'm drunk again, I swear this. Is just a curse. I got here by killing off all my friends. I think I figured out my life begins when fun ends. I got my wings, I'm free to go as I please. Yeah, got my wings, now nothing really pleases me till everything falls apart. Then I get to try to put it back together. Yeah, it falls apart, and you can count on that. You can count on bad, bad weather again. Was it? Tales. Now the devil is in my pants, and it's shoot first, apologize later, another quick and do short shot romance. Well, I got what I wanted, now I don't want anything. Yeah, I got what I wanted, now my life is just boring till everything falls apart. Then I get to try to put it back together. Yeah, it falls apart, and you can count on that. You can count on bad, bad weather again. I met God this afternoon, riding on an uptown train. I said, don't you have better things to do? He said, if I do my job, what would you complain about? So let it go to hell, now I'll have something to do. He said, I let it go to hell, doesn't that sound familiar to you? Oh yeah, well everything falls apart. Then I got to try to put back together. Yeah, it falls apart, and you can count on that. You can count on bad, bad weather. Well, everything that falls apart, baby, sooner or later gonna come back together. And everything that come together, yeah, sooner or later gonna fall apart. And you can call it anything you want. They're gonna take it all away from you. You're gonna wake up, wake up, wake up scared. Find yourself lost again. Lost again. Well, you're lost, but you're lost again.
Everything falls apart. Dog's Eye View. Yeehaw. Music Hall. How long ago did you write that song?
Just about a year ago. It was one of the last songs I wrote before going in to make the record. I kind of popped out on a plane after a week in New Orleans. I sat down all jittery and just, I'd been walking around New Orleans going, wow, everything here falls apart, man. And then got on a plane after being up all night and just kind of wrote it.
So you had God on a train, and Joan Osborne had God on a bus.
That's right.
Is there a thing going here?
I met God this afternoon. He said, what if I were one of you? Obviously that song wasn't out when I...
No, I know. It's just one of those weird mass transit coincidences.
Exactly. God on mass transit. He used to have a limo, but, you know, it's just...
Times are tough. Peter Stewart is the songwriter here. Now, that song...
Tim Bradshaw's the guitar player.
On first listen, that's a very upbeat, fun, like, yeah, positive, things are great song. And then you listen to the words, and it's really dark and very cynical. And a lot of your songs are like that, although you don't hear that on first blush. You got to spend some time with it.
Yeah, I mean, it's kind of... that's my favorite trick about pop music, I think. Without using it as a trick, for me personally, I get into songs because of the way they sound, and the songs that I love the most are the ones that 10 times later I go, wait, what's this about? You know, not the ones that immediately I play for someone and go, listen to this lyric or listen to this line or the story, are the ones that 2 times later I'm bored with. You know, it's like the reason you can't play comedy records over and over, because you know the end of the joke.
Yeah.
But that's, I really enjoy doing that. I mean, I write about darker things sometimes. I mean, there's always hope in them, or there's always something positive going on, but to me it's more fun to create this juxtaposition.
And to have the depth in it where you can listen, and like you said, 10 times into it, it's like, oh my God, I didn't hear that before.
It's just, I just want to, my big plot is to just get, you know, housewives walking around going, the devil is in my pants, before they really know what they're doing.
Right. So, now, you had all of your songs written before you got the band together to record?
Yeah, I was touring solo. So, I mean, I'd put various lineups of the band together while I was home, but I kept getting offered solo tours. And when someone says, hey, do you want to come open for us for months in front of large crowds, the choice between that and staying in New York and playing in front of 10 people, you know, biweekly doesn't match up. So I was just out on the road, and being out on the road and playing every night was making me write more and more. So then when it came time to make the record, I just got people together, and we went in and cut it really quickly without rehearsing it or anything. Just wow. Got good people.
Now, the band that's on the record is not the band that's with you on the road.
No. Well, the drummer's the same, but the bass player and guitar player simultaneously combusted.
Like a Spinal Tap thing.
Exactly. Yeah. New York's, the music scene in New York is not very band oriented. It's very opportunist oriented. So everyone just kind of plays with 7 or 8 different people. And
so then the question would be, why Dog's Eye View? Why not a Peter Stewart record? Because it is all your stuff, and
Yeah, but it is a band. I mean, whether it was the band on the record or the band live, it's still every night I prefer it to be a guitar player challenging me on a vocal line, or a guitar player feeling not like a backing band or not feeling like some subordinate, or you know, I just like everyone to feel a part of it. And I like everyone, I like the challenge of it. And I like the idea that someone's watching us going, oh, that's a cool band. Or like, I like Tim, or I like Dermot, you know, not going, yeah, Peter's backing band. Because then all the focus is on, it gets boring. I don't know. And I like bands better. I like, they excite me.
Okay. Dog's Eye View is the name of the band. It's also a line from one of the songs on the album, The Prince's Favorite Son. Which came first, the song or the...
The song, absolutely. Yeah, it was a year or two after I wrote that song that I was trying to figure out a band name and coming up with horrible names, you know. The Walls, yeah, great name. I was living in this basement apartment in Chicago, and all I could see, I just had this teeny little view of a fire hydrant. And so I was sitting there writing Prince's Favorite Son, kind of, you know, writing semi-stream of consciously going, you know, with dogs I view, it's a world full of hydrants, you know, someone's feet pass by, I'm like, passing feet, yeah, you never get the whole scene. And then the trick line in that song is, it took, I read 429 books around a better world, and April 29th is my birthday, so 429 is just, it's a little self-reference. I mean, so it's just, and then, you know, later on, ta-da, it's a band name.
Great. Okay, it's Dog's Eye View, Peter Stewart, in the Music Hall. Tomorrow night, Troubadour, will you do another song for us?
Yes, absolutely. Would you like Small Wonders, Haywire, Prince's Favorite Son?
Any of them.
Okay.
I love this record.
It's a medley.
Oh, cool.
It's medley time, Tim. We'll do Small Wonders. Here we go. Here we go again with your hair in your face, my head in my hands. Hoping to find something that we never know. Looking like two little kids with our wide eyes, slow tenderness, asking the same things that we always do. And when we're feeling we've been cheated out of something we deserve, then these small wonders keep us awake at night. These small wonders hold us down to the ground and show us who we are. Walking side by side with our fear and our hope, our love and our pride. Two steps forward and no looking back. Every chance to fall through, that's one look. The world becomes you one touch. We know we're on our way. And when we're feeling we've been wasted by too much time inside, then these small wonders keep us awake at night. These small wonders hold us down to the ground and show us who we are. before. The world comes screaming through our door. These small wonders, these small wonders. Here we go again. Your hair, my face, your hair.
Dog's Eye View in the Music Hall on FM 101.9. Thank you so much. It's Small Wonders, just one of a bunch of really good songs on this debut album, Happy Nowhere. Another kind of play on words. There's
Indeed.
So much to ask you. So go do your show at the Troubadour tomorrow night and go do your tour. How long is the tour going
to
last?
We're doing about a month and a half to start on our own, and then hopefully we'll hop on a tour with someone else. And I have no home, so I'm living out of a suitcase, so I can't stop touring.
Okay, well, go out, do your tour, sell about a million or two records, and then come back and visit us again.
Okay, can we come back in the meantime, like somewhere in between then?
Absolutely.
Okay, well, back tomorrow morning.
Because I have so many more questions to ask you. Okay, we'll see you tomorrow then. And tomorrow night at the Troubadour, Dog's Eye View. Thank you.
Our pleasure.
We'll see you soon.